Hi guys, maybe you saw the movie Soul from Pixar, and I read that they used a contact rig for the piano, and so I thought it would be cool to show you how you can do something like that in Blender. So let's go. Here's a piano from Blender Kit, and of course you can take whatever you want, but I will do it with this one. And what I've done here, I've joined everything together so that we only have our base mesh and the keys. You don't necessarily have to join everything together, but it's a bit easier for us if we have organized everything. For the keys, I would think about if you need all keys working, because normally we only need the middle part of the keyboard. That's why I will go here into the edit mode and then to the top view. And for example, I choose this range. Then I press Ctrl L to select everything and P. And selection, and then we will only use this part. Then we can hide everything that we don't need. And first of all, we add an armature, scale it down, put it up. Okay. We need it for the first key. Then we can go into the side view. And I would suggest go into the viewport display. No, here. Viewport display and display it as a stick. And select in front so that we can always see the bone. Yeah, then we have to put it here to the end and rotate it 90 degrees. Okay. Then we go into the edit mode and put it to the end. And now we have only this vertex selected. And then we press E and Z to extrude it and go a bit over the key like this. And then we select the bone and press Alt P to clear the parent so that it isn't connected anymore to the other bone. Now we have to go to the post mode. And select first this bone and then the other. And then we press Shift and I to add a constraint to the active bone. And now here we have to set the chain length to 1. All right. And now it's connected. Like this. Then we also have to limit the location of this bone. So we go to the constraints and select limit location. Here you can select everything and set it to local space. And for the y-axis, I would set it to -0.1, I would say. Then we can test it. And yeah, this looks pretty good. Later we will also need a copy location modifier, but to speed up the process, I will add it now. Then we have to put it up and we leave the target free for now. Yeah, and now it's time to do it also for the other keys. So we go into the edit mode and then to the top view, select everything with A. And press Shift D to duplicate it. Okay. And do it also for the other keys. All right. Now we can do it also for the upper keys. So we just select the first one, then go into the side view press Shift D to duplicate it and align it here. We have to scale it a bit down. Yeah, I think this looks pretty good. Then we go to the top view again and align it here. And duplicate it. Nice. Now we put the bones in different layers so that we have the long bones in one layer and the short bones in the other layer. For that, just select the long bones first. Press Ctrl L to select everything of the bone. And then press M. And here we can take this layer, for example. And now we can see here the different layers. Now we can go to the object mode again and press Ctrl P and select armature deform with empty groups. Then we select the keys first and then the armature and press Ctrl P and say armature deform with empty groups. Now it's time to assign the keys to the bones, and to make it a bit easier for you, you can select show names under the viewport display so that you can see the names of every bone. And first of all, you have to select the armature. Then shift select the keys and go into the edit mode. Select a vertex of the first key, press Ctrl L, and then we want to assign it to the first bone. So here under the vertex groups, we search for bone and click on assign. And now we have to make the same process for the other keys as well. So the second key is bone 28. We select a vertex, Ctrl L, and here we search for bone 28 and assign it. So now you can do it for the other keys as well, and see you soon. After you have done everything, you can deactivate the names again, and we can try it out by going into the other layer and then into the pose mode and just move it. And yeah, awesome. It works pretty nice. One thing, if the movement of the keys is too high or too low, then you can go into the constraints, and on the limit location you can adjust it here. So for example, I set it to -0.05, and as you can see, the movement isn't so big anymore. If you want to apply the change on all the other bones, then you can just select all bones you want, then press Alt. And while pressing Alt, just type the number you want. So in our case, -0.1. And now we want that the keys are dynamically interacting with an object. So we first go into the object mode again and add a new cube. Scale it down. Put it up. Basically, what we want is that the cube is at the front of the first key. So something like this. We can set the viewport display of the cube to wire so that we can see the key better. And then we go to the top view. Scale it more down. Something like this, so that the cube is covering the front of the key. And here, also a bit up. All right. We can put the cubes in a different collection because we don't need to render it later, and we can deactivate it for rendering. So we just call it keys, put it in, and now we go into the object data properties and add a new vertex group. And now we go into the edit mode, press A to select everything and assign everything. Okay. And then we select our armature and go into the pose mode, select the first bone, and here as the target we choose the cube. And now if we move the cube, the key is also moving. But also don't forget to select the vertex group for the cube we added earlier so that we don't get in trouble with the next step. Then we go back to object mode again and select the cube. And we add a dynamic paint to the cube, add canvas, set the end frame very high, infinity. We set the surface type to displays, and yeah, the displays factor can be very high. Yeah, 50 is the highest. Here also the radius set to 10, and then we activate dissolve, deactivate slow, and set the time to 1. Before we duplicate the cube, I adjust the size a bit. So we can go to the top view again, and then go into edit mode, toggle X-ray, and make it a bit longer so that we have a bigger contact surface. Maybe here also a bit more space. All right. And now we can duplicate it for all keys. So we just press Shift D. Yep. All right. Then we make it also for the upper keys. So we just duplicate it. And then we can go to the side view, scale it a bit more down to something like this. Here. Now we select all cubes by going to the keys collection, right click, select objects, and shift select the armature and go into the pose mode. And under the constraints, we can assign the cubes to the bones now. So for this bone, we choose as the target this cube, and you also have to select the vertex group. And for this bone, we select this cube and this bone, this cube, and so on. So just make it like that and see you soon. If you have assigned everything, then we can now add a sphere, for example. UV sphere, make it smaller. Smaller. And then we add a dynamic paint to the sphere also, and we set the type to brush, add brush, and for the paint we set it to mesh volume and proximity. And now, yeah, as you can see, it works. And keep in mind that the contact surface for the keys is only as big as the cubes. So in this case, I did it only until here because I just wanted to avoid that you accidentally press the down key if you press the upper key a bit too much down. But of course, if you want that everything should be affected, then you can just select the down keys here. And go into edit mode, then top view, and here we toggle X-ray and put it to the end. Okay, then we can do this also for the upper keys. Edit mode and here. The last important thing to know is the more the cubes are subdivided, the more precise is everything. So, for example, if I scale down the sphere, it can happen that it doesn't intersect with the keys sometimes. And what you can do here is we go to the keys, we select everything, go into edit mode, press A to select everything, right mouse button, subdivide, and subdivide it like 5 times, for example. And now it should work better. Yep. And now we can just deactivate the collection with the keys. Put the armature in this collection and also activate the other objects, and here we go. Okay, I had pretty much fun doing this and I hope you too, and if so, then please leave a thumbs up or a comment below so that YouTube doesn't hate me too much, and yeah, see you in the next video.